Hey guys, so this week on Jazz Tutorials, I'm going to show you how to make a really cool vector. Now, we've made vectors in the past in Illustrator, but I'm going to show you a way to make a cool vector in Photoshop. Now, this can be done in Illustrator as well, but I just thought that most of you won't have Illustrator, so I thought I would show you something cool in a vector stance in Photoshop. Basically, what we're making is we're making a Christmas ornament. It's, you know, December, so I figured let's try and cater to the December seasonal type of tutorials. I mean, they won't all be seasonal, just this particular one will be, and maybe a couple others. So, to start things off, as you'll notice, I have a background already set up with a gradient. Now, I've chosen a light blue to a black hue with a radial selection. But that's optional, you don't really need to do that, but I'm doing it just to show you the tutorial. But you can certainly find backgrounds on Google.com or DeviantArt that are really seasonal, like a Christmas tree background or a snowflake type background. Basically, I'll be using a snowflake background towards the end. I'll show you that. And yeah, let's just get started. So as you'll notice, I have a really cool, a really smaller circle already made. Now you can make your ornament whatever size you would like. I have a bigger ornament I will show you in here, but just so you can see how to make the ornament, sort of, we're going to start off with a small circle. So start off with a small-ish circle, and then once you make your small circle, you want to then make another circle that's slightly bigger than your small circle, and your circle can be any color you like. I chose a really cool blue. Just because I thought it was really a seasonal. Blue is kind of, you know, outdoorsy, snowflake-like color, so I thought I would choose that. But again, you can choose whatever colors you like. I have no preference here. Okay, so once you have your sphere, let me make my other big sphere so you can see exact, because I really would feel like an idiot if I didn't show you the entire tutorial. So you want to have your smaller sphere in the dead center. And you want to also make sure that your other sphere you've made is the same color, not white. Okay, now is where the fun begins. We're going to grab our gradient tool. That's right, blow your eraser tool if you didn't know that. And you want to have a radial gradient with a mode of multiply. And make sure your dither is checked, not checked off for this, because we're going to be doing some cool stuff to it and we don't need that. Alright, and with white is your selection, and a new layer above that. Alright, you need to have a new layer. You're going to then, make a new layer. And you're going to then put a line right through it. Just create a circle like that. And Control-T and put it. You may have to resize it, but you want to kind of center it so that it gives that spherical look. There we go. Now you may need to erase some of it so that it blends in a bit, but just to show you what I mean, you'll see now that it's very more spherical-like. Okay, now we need to add some effects onto the sphere that we've just created. So what I'm going to do is just so it's easy to add the effects on top of everything and not just going by one layer, one layer, one layer, I then merged my previous three layers together. But before doing so, I made a duplicate of those three layers and hid them just in case I make a mistake somewhere along the line. Not that I would, but if I did, I can always go back and fix it. So before you go ahead and merge those together, select all of your three layers you just made, and you'll go up here to Layer, and you want to select Duplicate Layers. It's going to give you a message of sort, and just click OK, and then it will then duplicate them. And then with the duplicated layers, you can then go to Layer, and then you can select Merge Layers, and that will then merge those three together into one. And then you can continue with your next step. So, yay to that. Okay, I'm going to now hide this because I've already done this. Okay. So, on your merged layer now, I'll hide that. You're going to then double-click it. Alright, we're going to add an inner shadow. And I've chosen white for my blend mode color, and normal is my chosen blend mode. 75% opacity with a 55 degree angle. Distance is 59 pixels, or px, I like to say. and your choke is 0 and your size is 36. Okay, got that coolness. Let's keep going. Inner glow. I've chosen a screen blend mode, which that's, I think, standard, but if yours is not on screen, make it screen. I've chosen a 20% opacity with a white color of choice. Choke is 0 and your size is 68 pixels. And down here on your quality, your range is 91% and your jitter is 58%. Okay, we're good there. One more step. Then we're going to add a pattern overlay. Choose color burn and choose 63% opacity. Now this pattern here is already in Photoshop. It's a standard thing. You should have it. If you don't, you may have to load it, but it is there. If you go over here to your little arrow, it has a bunch here. I believe it's under texture fill. I have two texture fills because I was a cool kid and loaded them twice. So it's texture fill, and it's this one here. All right, so click that, and you're good. And then when you go and make it visible, look at that. Oh, that's awesome, right, guys? So much awesome. Now, I have two. Now, I have two spheres because I was originally going to make two of the same, one with a different, like, globy-like thing, but I chose not to, so I just have the one. So I'm going to hide my other one that we just made. And you'll notice how I have stuff inside of it. Let me explain that before we go any further because you're probably really confused by that right now. All right, now we're going to import a photo of choice into the globe to give it more of a really like ornamenty like feel. So I just went to google.com, typed in Christmas tree lights, and I got this really cool Christmassy photo. So go ahead to google.com right now and choose a photo you like. I don't care what it is. It's whatever you want. I don't care. You could even use a picture of your dog if you really wanted to. That's up to you. And when you choose your photo, you're going to then import it into Photoshop. And let me unclip this so you can see what I'm talking about, because right now it's clipped and that's going to be confusing to you. All right. So unclip that for just show and tell. And as you'll notice, I have it blended in really well with this, so you can't really see too well. But anyhooser, I just chose a Christmas photo. And when you import it into Photoshop, you're going to have to resize and twist it and turn it so that it looks really good with yours. And then upon doing so, you're going to add a clipping mask, which is basically holding down your Alt key so the paint bucket appears, and boom. And that will then make it so that it's inside that globe and not outside anywhere else, which also saves you somewhat of a hassle of erasing parts you don't want. Then when you do so, it'll look really, really ridiculously bright and too crazy. You could just alter the opacity if you wanted to, but for me, I felt like if you used a brush, that would really blend it in really nice. So I added a mask layer to mine. I went to Layer, and I selected Layer Mask, and I chose Reveal All, because that's not how you make a mask. That's just one of the ways you can create a mask onto your layer. I just chose Reveal All, so that way it would reveal everything into the photo, and nothing would get messed up in any way. So once you have your Reveal All mask onto that layer, you can then go ahead and choose a large eraser brush, and just erase a bit so that it blends in with your lovely globe. Okay, that's all cool and stuff, but I still think it needs more. So I then redid that photo. I did the same exact thing again, and I added it onto the opposing side. So clipping mask to that as well. Just a bit. Okay. All right, there we go. So now I got both of mine in there. And again, you'll have to add another Reveal All mask to that, and you'll have to mask out the parts you don't want to see that make it blend in more nicely and cool. Alright, now that's the kind of the basics of making an ornament in Photoshop. But to really make it look exactly like a real ornament, you need to have the little top thing, right? I don't even know what they call it. It's just the metal top to your ornament. Is there a real name for that? If there is, someone comment below and tell me, because I don't know what it's called. But it's the metal thing on top. We gotta make that. So make a new layer above everything. And by above everything, I mean on top of the entire, like, layers you have. If you didn't know, but I'm sure you did. So new layer above that. Alright, cool. Now, if you're really an artsy person, then you can draw a perfect one. Mine, however, is not perfect. So, I'm sorry if it's not perfect, but you're going to have to zoom in very far. Now, I drew this with a brush, by the way. This is not like a real Photoshop picture from Google.com. I drew this. So, if it looks butchered, I'm sorry, but I did the best I could. So, there you go. That's the little green tassel. I mean, the green tassel. Wow. The metal tassel thingy on the top of your ornament. Now, you have to really make that look official. So, to that, double-click it. Add a gradient overlay. I did a really kind of darkish green, yellowish green, dark green color. I don't even know what you want to call that. Like, a mucky color. And I did that to transparency. And I chose reverse, and I used linear with a 144-degree angle. I dropped the opacity on that to 50%, and that's the effect I got there. Now it looks more metallic and more realistic, so yay. Now, just when you think we're finished, we are not. We still have to make the loop, because what's a Christmas ornament without the loop, right? So let's go add that. Boom! We made it. Well, I drew that. So just draw. If you have good hands, you can free draw that. If you don't have good hands and you can't really draw the top part, you can just find an image on Google.com, but I just think it looks cooler if you draw it yourself. So be creative and try and draw this exact image on the top of your globe like I have. And I just chose, as you notice, a really bright yellowish color to blend that in. Okay! We're almost done, I promise. And I just added another layer, by the way, if you didn't notice, of just to blend in that little top part, but you don't have to do that if you don't want it. I just did. So, yay. Okay, we're almost done. Now, I added another layer, and I put on some, I just put like a blue dot right there and blended that in, because I felt like my image needed it. Yours may not. It's up to you. It's optional. Drop my opacity to 84%, and yay. All right, and the final step to this tutorial, we have to have the ribbon. You cannot have an ornament without a ribbon to go with it. It's just not fair to your Christmas tree, because how else will we hang it, right? So I grabbed a ribbon brush that I found on my computer. I downloaded this off of a random site. I can't even remember now. It's been so long since I found this brush. But if you go to google.com and type in ribbon brushes for Photoshop, you can find a ribbon brush you like. I'll provide this one for the link down below in case you want to use it. But if you want to use your own, that's cool too. And obviously I chose red because red's a good color. And boom. I stashed the ribbon through there. And that's it. This just triggered. I forgot to show you my snowflake background that I added. Wow, my mind just went totally blank and I was ending the video on a bad note. So I added a snowflake background, like such, and that's what I got. I found this image on Google.com, and I thought it was cool, so I added it to this, and I have it set to screen, because for me that really worked well with mine. But again, you have to do this, it's optional, but I just think it brings it out more, it makes it more Christmassy and themed, so that's what I did there. That's the tutorial. That's how you make a cool little globe vector in Photoshop. I hope this was awesome. I hope you liked it. I liked it. It was cool. It was a lengthy video, and I apologize. If you stuck around to the end, you're awesome. I love you. You're awesome. Not that you weren't awesome before, but you're just still, you're awesome for staying around, because not many people stick around for over 10 minutes. I mean, that's impressive. Just saying. Anyways, thank you for watching, thank you for commenting if you did, liking if you did that as well, and subscribing if you are. If you're not a subscriber, click my yellow button, or whatever color button it is. I post videos at least once a week. I try to do twice a week, but sometimes it's only one. So if you like this, I'm glad. If you didn't, I'm sorry. If you have any suggestions of videos or things you want to make, or have any questions about something that you want to make a video about, comment below, inbox me here. I have an email as well. You can find that on our website and all that good stuff. All my links of where you can find me are linked below. All the downloads are below. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.